Hi everyone. Hello. Hi. Hi everybody. Welcome to tonight's Club Live. I'm Radhika and I'm going to host tonight's very special Club Live. Hello. So we have a very special guest today, and her name's Jasmeet, and I will be patching her in. We're just going to wait for a few people to join. She is a makeup artist. She's featured on various platforms. She recently featured on Vogue, and Vogue has called her the best bridal makeup artist in Delhi. So I'm just gonna patch her in. Hi Rithi, hi Anjali, hi Pinky. I'm trying to get Jasmeet to join us. Hi Rishita. Hello. I think that's some issue I'm gonna get. Jasmeet to join us. We're waiting. Hi, Gauri. Hi, Jasmeet.
Hi. How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Good. Thank you. I'm so sorry about the delay. It's my fault.
Okay.
Not really my fault, but the delay was from.
Okay, so guys, Jasmeet is a makeup artist. She is a hair and makeup artist. Her signature look is minimalistic, simplistic. She's all about that natural glow. And she is called the best bridal makeup artist by Vogue. Am I right?
One of, yes.
One of the best makeup artists. And all those brides who are looking for a natural look on their D-Day, just needs your girl. So, what are we doing today, Jasmeet?
Today, I'm going to talk about lashes. Not about false lashes, but to make your own lashes look, well, more enhanced and just fuller than a lot of people are familiar with how to use kajal or eyeliner properly. But when it comes to mascara, I feel a lot of us are lacking. And I was, you know, before I knew better. So I feel like this is a good thing to kind of share. Just little things that can help lift up your eyes, make them look bigger. Right. So that's what I'm here to talk about.
All right. So maybe we can get going and let's show our viewers what you have to show us.
Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to remove my eyeliner just so it's so my lashes are more visible because we're concentrating on those today.
One of our viewers asking if we should be applying mascara or eyeliner first.
Eyeliner first.
Eyeliner first. Okay. All right.
That's because when you, once you had your, put your mascara on, your lashes are up and it's difficult to kind of get in there and put your eyeliner on. So once your eyeliner is nice and even and smoothly applied, then you add your mascara right at the end.
Right. Okay.
I like to apply mascara right at the end after your full makeup application because if you're using any powders or concealers or anything else, it's very easy to get onto your lashes. And then your lashes like foundation basically. Easily. So mascara right at the end for your lashes to look really nice and dark. So I'm just gonna remove my eyeliner.
I'm going to see if there are any questions and we're going to take some questions from the viewers.
Yeah. Let me know.
I love that excitement. Okay, so we have a question. So we put in a few we put in a question sticker right before the live, and we have a few questions from people. So they know, how do you make your natural lashes look longer?
That's what I'm here for. That's what I'm going to
show. So she's going to show you everything. And also, which is the best mascara?
That also I'm going to talk about today. Okay. Not too. I'm going to give you lots of details. Answer.
Tell you guys, Jasmeet, recently, a bride that she worked with got featured in BBC. And there was a whole coverage on her. So she's known as the bride who wore a pantsuit to her wedding. So how was that like, Jasmeet?
It was amazing. She messaged me just a few days, Sanjana. She messaged me just a few days before her wedding. Yes. I think maybe 3 or 4 days before the wedding. And the wedding was to happen in November.
Okay.
And she was like, you know what, forget it. We're just going to do it. So that's how it happened. And she sent me a photo. She said, this is what I'm wearing. This was all over Instagram. We didn't even talk on the phone. And I was a bit surprised. I was like, oh, wow. That's all I had to say. And she said, yeah, it's okay. Take some time for it to settle in. Take your time. Wrap your head around it. But she looked great.
Amazing.
Yeah. She pulled it off. And a lot of people have been saying a lot of crap about her. But she doesn't give two hoots, which is great. I feel like more of us need to be like that. But she looked great. I feel like her aesthetic in general is great. I loved it. A lot of people loved it. People who don't understand the aesthetic just didn't understand it, and that's fine. You know, everyone can't love everything, and that's okay. But yeah, she got a lot of love for that look.
She looked amazing. So what are you doing next after you remove?
Okay, I like to start off always, no matter how nice or how full your lashes are, one of these eyelash colors, you know, they
always
Sorry?
Do you recommend a specific eyelash color or any works?
You know, so I've realized this. The cheaper ones, the inexpensive ones, don't really work that well. I mean, I know it's just a piece of metal and a rubber strip here, but I've always found a good brand one, it works a lot better. This is just from MAC. I'm going to use stuff that's easily available here. So this one from MAC, it always helps to kind of just place it. And I'm sure everyone knows how to use one of these. Our moms have always used these.
Eyelash color, I'm always scared.
I know it can be a bit scary. People have had bad experiences, but can you see that? Can you see this hair?
The difference, yes.
Yeah, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to do everything on one eye.
Okay.
Just so you guys, right?
Yes, and I can.
All right, so maybe there's not such a vast difference. But for a lot of people, especially people who have smaller eyes, the lashes, if they're straight, they can make your eyes look even smaller. So this is a great... Look at this. You can see the difference. I can tell the difference. The edge is just lifted.
So it looks bigger, the one that you're working with right now.
Yeah. So this is something that everyone knows about. Guys, I mean, look at this. My eyes are not even small, but you can tell the difference already.
So do you also prefer heating your eyelash curler before using it? Because I've seen a lot of people do that.
It's not required. If you just place it correctly, I like to tilt it at an angle.
Mm-hmm.
It's at an angle. So, you know, if it's straight, you might get your skin stuck in here. But if it's at an angle, it's resting on your eyelid and it's just catching the right amount. So you pump. You can pump 7 or 8 times and also just hold it. Keep it pressed down till 10 or something and then just leave it. So your lashes go up. Another tool I want to talk about is a mini curler. This is the regular curler. Okay. This is a mini curler. This one is also from... Sorry?
The lashes also get curled because most of the times when we're curling with an eyelash curler, that only curls the middle part.
Exactly. So this is... And it's shaped. It's not even curved. It's straighter.
So
you can kind of get in there. And can you see these lashes that are caught in here?
Yeah.
You know, my lashes get all caught in at one time in this, so it's okay for me. For people who have longer eyes or droopy eyes, all of you have eyes, just get this. You'll see the difference. You'll thank me later. All the lashes that are coming downwards, they don't get caught in the regular curler. So you need one of these. Same process. Tilt it, pump it, and hold it. And
I can see that.
Yes. I mean, if you can't see my lash standing up, you can see how open this eye suddenly is, right? Okay, now step two is mascara. A lot of people ask me, what mascara should we get? Should we get a Dior? Should we get a Chanel, Bobbi Brown? I use Maybelline mascaras.
Okay.
Maybelline brand. I know it's a drugstore brand, but it is great. They were around before anyone else was. So they have literally aced the mascara game. So again, just to show everyone that drugstore mascara is just fine. So I've got this, the usual, the normal Colossal mascara. So the way to apply this correctly to really see results is to place it at the bottom, right at the base of your lashes, and then wiggle it out. Sit and wiggle.
Right.
You know, a lot of people just do this at the tip and they think that's it, but that's, it doesn't work like that. So you place it here. And you wiggle it out.
Is asking which brand is this? This is Maybelline, the yellow voluminous mascara. That's what she's using right now.
Colossal. So you can do a couple layers of this. You don't have to just do one. So pro tip coming up. Once this dries a little bit, you know, go in with a second mascara.
Okay.
Again, this one is just a different kind. Once it becomes a little bit tacky, just go in with a second mascara.
Right.
And this really, really just lifts up.
I can see the difference. Looks great.
Yeah. And this is just like one or two coats. You know, this is not even like a full crazy application. So you can see the difference.
Yes, I can. It looks great.
It does. And you know, when you're coating the base, it also makes your inner lash line dark, which gives it a really nice definition, even if you don't want to wear eyeliner. Or people with small lids don't like to wear eyeliner because it covers the whole lid. So this is a great way. Tight lining is another option, but this just does it for you.
Okay, people are asking. So viewers want to know, what brand is the small eyelash curler? Which brand
this is it? This one is also MAC. I'm using everything that's available here. It's impossible to get stuff from abroad now due to lockdown. Duties on everything are 80%, so guys, just forget it. There's no point ordering anything. Shu Uemura is a great brand. If you're traveling, if someone's coming in, they can carry it for you. Shu Uemura make the best lash curlers in the world. But use MAC and you saw the difference. So this works perfectly. Let me try to show you from a different angle. Can you see that?
Yes, I can.
Yeah. And yeah. And I have big eyes, so I don't necessarily need this step, but putting mascara at the bottom.
So another question, let's take in another question. People want to know, how do you avoid getting mascara on your eyelids while you're applying it?
I mean, okay, so if your chin is up and you're looking down into the mirror like this and then applying, your lashes are down, they're not up. You know, if you're looking straight like I was, you can get dots here and it's actually not that difficult to remove. But if you're looking down, your lashes are down, they're away from your eyelid. You'll never get any marks on your lid. So just look down, fan it a little bit, it'll dry out. Now on top, if I add eyeliner, it'll look even more enhanced.
Right.
But also what a lot of people do is they curl their lashes after putting mascara. That's not something to do. A lot of mishaps take place because of that. Mascara is still tacky, you know, and your curlers get stuck in it and your lashes pull and people lose their lash hair, be quite a disaster. So this is one way. Now, I'll show you what people usually do, which is what I've seen most people do. My friends do it. My cousins do it. They'll take mascara and they'll do this.
Right. That's what I do.
You know? And it, you know, I mean, you see the lashes, but there's a world of a difference.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, this is, it's fine if that works for you. Great. But I feel like this is effective. You know, some sisters of the brides, or when I'm doing party makeup, some people just don't like to wear false lashes. It makes them uncomfortable. You know, they're not used to it. It's just not their vibe, or it's too much. So just put on a couple layers of mascara, you know, pump their lashes up really nicely and they're fine. They're good to go. So how to.
Okay. Can you
adopt
to our audience, because they want to know the brands again. So just show both the mascaras once.
This is, I mean, they're both Maybelline. This is the, it's called Push Up Drama. And this is the usual Colossal, the most common, the most readily available. And it's all of 400 rupees. So you don't have to spend thousands on a branded mascara. They all work the same if you use them the right way. Also, I do not recommend using waterproof mascaras on a daily basis. They do dry out your lashes get clumpy, they break easily. Use waterproof mascaras only on special occasions, on weddings, or during the monsoon, actually, when you feel like there might be a chance. But yeah, also, in the market now, there are lots of products, FDA approved products that you can use for lashes. One of them is Farah here. And Farah will testify to this. She's here. Farah, hi. It's called Lumigan.
Okay.
And she, yeah, there she is. It's readily available at any chemist. It's a little green bottle, I think. I don't have it here. I don't use it. But she does. It's basically eye drops. But them at night before going to bed with a brush or an earbud. Put them on your lashes. Your lashes will grow like this.
Oh, yeah. So we actually got a few questions asking what oil do you use to make your lashes longer? So Anjali asked this question. This is for her.
Lumigan is a great product. Farah has used it. Her lashes are insane. She doesn't even need mascara.
Okay.
They're longer. They're just... and it's so easily available. It's inexpensive. So I feel like it's a great product. Safe to use because it's actually meant to be put inside your eyes. So there's no harm caused. It's FDA approved. Okay. Lumigan. Yeah, Farah, just mention it there, please.
So that's Lumigan for eye drops. So that actually helps your eyelashes grow. Am I right?
It's not a regular eye drop. It's to cure something inside the eyes. Okay. But it's been proven. People use it to grow their lashes all the time. And Farah, who's one of my closest friends, uses it all the time. So pin the product name. Can you pin it? I don't. 1 second. I'll try to pin Farah's comment. I don't know if I can.
Okay. And also, yeah.
Farah, what's the other name? What's the new name it's marketed under? Lumigan, it's called something else. Coconut oil is... Rushal, I haven't tried it to grow lashes. I'm sure it works.
And what would you recommend? Which mascara would you recommend for sunken eyes?
Like I said, any mascara is great if you use it the right way.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The bottom and just wiggle it out.
Right. And also, people are asking, what is the best way to remove mascara? So most of the times you remove your mascara and your eyelids tend to come out or fall off.
Yeah, so that happened with waterproof mascara.
Right.
That happened with water. That's why you don't use it every day. Use it only when you absolutely need to.
Right.
1 second. Latisse, yeah, that's the new name. Whenever you remove your mascara, and it's the same for false lashes, if you're wearing them, don't ever rip them out like that. You literally tear in, you know, on your eyelid. It's so. Take any oil, whether it's oil, coconut oil, or just baby oil. Take it on cotton, dab it, the oil settle into your skin or into your lashes, and then wipe it off. Leave it there for 8 to 10 seconds, and then just clean it out.
Okay. So for all those people enjoying our 30-minute lives, I would recommend that you go into our bio and click the link and register to be a part of our Air Black Beauty family and enjoy all our sessions.
Yeah. Any other questions regarding lashes, guys?
We have bio a lot oil of foundations and primers. Okay, so we have a question. What about bio oil and castor oil? So I believe bio oil and castor oil also helps in the growth of your lashes. Is that true?
The thing is, I used castor oil on my lashes once, and I wasn't very comfortable. So that's the reason. I mean, I never use it again. I know it works on your head, and I used to use it on my brows. So I mean, I'm sure it works, but just I use it on my lashes. It went inside. It made me very uncomfortable. So Lumigan does castor oil. Maybe it was just me. Maybe it was the oil, or maybe that batch specifically. Castor oil is great for hair growth. You're right. But it just made my eyes itch. So I don't like to recommend it. You can try it. If it works for you, then great. It's a great product. But again, Lumigan is tried and tested. Easy. And probably much cheaper than castor oil. So why not?
Okay. Let's try to see if we have some questions regarding lashes. How can we clean false lashes? And should we wash them? Kritika wants to know.
There's a tutorial on my page, actually. It's probably way back. You take a cotton pad, put your lash on it. Micellar water. Micellar water. What's that other one? The bio or something. Spray some on the lash. And place another cotton pad on top of it. And let it sit there. It's there. It's very easy to clean false lashes. Also, you have to make sure that they're reusable. A lot of people try to use the cheaper lashes again. Those are not reusable. Only the expensive, the ones or the other ones, the real hair ones, those are reusable. Don't try to reuse the plastic ones because it's not the same thing. You can't clean them out nicely and then they get clumpy.
Right. Okay, I hope that answered your question, Kritika.
What else? What
your non-waterproof mascara with a waterproof one, will it smudge?
No.
Nana wants to know this.
It won't smudge.
Great.
What else's lashes? Yeah. So like I said, use it at an angle.
Okay, yeah. Just make how for us, probably a quick eyeliner with your mascara, or maybe you've already applied the mascara, so you can't show us an eyeliner. Right.
I can try. Okay. So another thing about eyeliner, and this is also for budding makeup artist, you know, it's very, I mean, at least people around me that I see every day, they get very disheartened when they can't put eyeliner properly for their clients. I used to be scared at the thought of a wing liner. I'm like, oh my God, what, I can't get it. Well, this, that, it's the most natural thing. Like some, I know some big makeup artists who still can't do a wing liner properly. So it's not a big deal. Eyeliner is very tricky. You have to find the one that works for you. There are so many. Obviously, there's the usual pencil. There's the felt tip pen, the thin one. There's gel, there's pots. I like to use this. Again, this is just from L'Oreal. It's the black lacquer super liner.
A felt tip? Yes, it is.
It's a felt tip. So the only trick that I feel like works for everyone is to be in front of a mirror, don't hold the mirror. Be in front of it, have both your hands free. Rest your elbow on a table or something. Rest your elbow so your hand is stable.
Okay.
I don't have anything to rest my elbow on, so I'm just going to do it just like that. But So your other hand is free. You can stretch it out a little bit. You don't have to pull it too hard, but just kind of make it. And your elbow's resting here, so your hand's stable. You know, you're not shaking.
Right.
And just hold it, and you can start in the middle. You can start at the side, whatever works for you. And again, depending on your eye shape, if you just want to do a half line or do that, I like to do a full one for myself. Also, when you pull it a little bit, any creases get straightened out. You know, some people have wrinkles on their lips, so that causes uneven application. So you just pull it a little bit and small strokes. You don't have to be a pro the first time you do it.
And which eyeliner, you tell us again?
So easy.
Which eyeliner is this?
This is the L'Oreal Paris Black Lacquer Super Liner. It's available everywhere. It's 600 rupees. There's no need to go and buy expensive 1,000 rupee pots from anywhere. And it's super dark. You know, this is actually a lot darker than some of the bigger brands. Someone said I haven't gotten a single answer. Who is that? What is your question? Please ask again.
Okay, so my Kritika, any reason why eyes irritate after applying lashes? I use the packed one. Okay.
After putting lashes, now just lift them up like this. Like place your finger under your base and shift the lashes up. Sometimes they're too low, so they can end up irritating the inside of your eye. Lift them up. Also try to use mascara after applying your false lashes. Mascara will lift them up for you permanently and they won't irritate you anymore. Try this because that always helps my clients. Thank you, Bhakti. Someone said their questions are not answered. One second.
No,
please ask your question again. Otherwise, I'm sorry. I don't know how to find it. How do there's a tutorial on my highlights. Please go watch the eyeshadow tutorial. Why don't you pick the questions? I'll just let you pick.
When applying of fake lashes, which part should you attach first?
The outside. Always the outside. Place the outside and then take it inwards.
All right. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's ask more
questions. In the science, but it always works best.
What is the lash glue just made according to you?
The best lash glue? Huda. I like the Huda lash glue.
Okay. Great. So why don't you show us a little close-up of your lashes and the viewers.
My lashes.
Yes.
I don't know if you can.
I wish we had a before and after picture. That looks great.
The side, right? They're like.
Yeah.
Up. The only reason they're up is because of the colors. I mean, they could be still nice and dark because of the mascara, but they take that nice shape because you've curled them nicely. You know, if it's taking you a while to get used to this, put your mascara on, let it dry for at least 20 minutes and then curl again. Then you'll get an even better, but you must let it dry. Otherwise you'll pull your lashes out and then you'll curse me. So please, 20 minutes at least.
That sounds great. So I hope you all liked the hack shown by Just Me. I loved it. I'm going to use it. And
yes. Hope it was helpful. Okay, well, right on time, actually, 8:30. I'll make a question box on my Insta story, guys. You can leave all your questions there. I'd be happy to answer them tomorrow. But thank you so much for having me. And this was great. And good luck for your other sessions. I'll see you soon. Bye. Bye. Good.